Hi there, Graham here from monumentphotos.co.uk. Welcome to another short photography tutorial. We're here in Galaxy Gym in Kilburnie, which is a new facility opened in the Radio City building. We're delighted to be joined today by beautiful Hannah Gunn. Hannah's an award-winning fitness model, cheerleader. She runs her own fitness programs, nutrition. So we'll put links below to some of that stuff later on. So she's going to go and warm up. I'm going to unpack some of the gear. We'd like to be using Profoto B1s again. And we'll get set up and take it from there. Okay, so we're pretty much set up ready to take a first test shot here. What I'm going to focus on today is aperture priority. We'll try and get a couple of photography tips in here, but we'll try and focus mainly on aperture just to see the difference that makes to a shot. You'll see on top of your camera, usually in a DSLR, you'll have four different letters, M-A-S-P. They stand for manual, aperture priority, shutter priority, and program. Okay, program is just really fully automatic. If you're a new photographer, then that's a good one to start with, and all you have to worry about is composition. Once you've advanced past that stage, you might want to then try aperture priority or shutter priority. Aperture priority, you simply change the aperture you want, the camera will calculate the shutter speed for you. Or alternatively, you can go into the shutter speed and the camera will calculate the aperture. If you're shooting in manual like I'm about to do, then basically you're taking control of both. Now I want to show you the difference aperture makes to a shot. So I'm going to take a photograph first of all of Hannah. And we're going to go with a small aperture. Remember, a small aperture means that the majority of the photograph is going to be sharp from foreground to background. So let's fire at a f16 and we'll see the results. So Hannah, if you just look this way and give us a lovely smile. Okay, so then we've got a shot at f16 and you'll see that the foreground and the background are all razor sharp. So that's a good shot for Galaxy Gym. It showcases their facility and also shows the model. Okay, so we're now going to take a shot with a large aperture. And obviously when you've got a large aperture, the light's going to travel through faster, which is why you need a faster shutter speed. So here I'm at f1.4 and we're going to shoot at 1,000th of a second. Let's see the results we get. Okay, Hannah gives a nice smile again. Perfect. This time you'll see that the model is perfectly sharp, the background's thrown out of focus, and it just gives a lot more priority to the subject. Okay, so we're going to set up a proper studio shot here with the Profoto B1 lights. I've been using these now for a couple of months and they're really fantastic lights. One of the great features is you can shoot at 1/8000th of a second. So you can really kind of crank up the speed on your shots, and most studio lights are really limited to 1/250th of a second. So it means when you can go as fast as that, you can open up your aperture really wide and get much more of a shallow depth of field. The top here, we've got an Air Remote TTL. We're using two Profoto lights, and this Air Remote TTL is fantastic. On Group A, we can simply, from the camera without moving, we can change the settings on Group A or B, turn on or off the modern lights and so on, and you've got some TTL settings through the lens which will calculate it for you. Or you can switch on to manual and power up one or other depending on the look you're going for. So let's take a couple of shots. We're going to use a colour gel actually for this one. You'll see Hannah's wearing a lovely purple outfit, and Profoto do a range of different coloured gels. So we've picked out a nice one here to match Hannah's outfit. And let's say I use that as a backlight and it should tie the whole thing in together. Okay, so for the next photograph here, what we're going to do is we're going to use the 2-foot beauty dish. The way a beauty dish works is the light comes in from the back here, bounces off the plate and then fills out, gives you a lovely directional light. So we're going to use a 2-foot beauty dish for this one. At the back again, we have up in the corner, we have one of the Profoto B1 lights with a coloured gel, and it's really just going to act as a backlight or a hair light for Hannah. Now when you're taking a photograph, when you want to compose it, the best thing to do is look for lead-in lines, something of visual interest. When we're shooting an aperture of f2.8, it's going to give us a nice shallow depth of field. So I'm going to crouch down here, and I'm going to take a shot of Hannah, and all of these weights in the foreground should be out of focus. That looks beautiful, Hannah. and it'll also throw the background out of focus too. That's perfect, Hannah. The foreground's very blurred and the leading lines are taking us straight to our model here. It looks fantastic. Well, I hope you enjoyed this short tutorial video from monumentphotos.co.uk. Remember to find us on Facebook, like the page, and also click subscribe on the video below. Subscribe to the video. Yeah. You can also find some of Hannah's work as well. Hannah, tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, if you go on to www.hannahgunn.com, you can find my ebooks there, and I'm releasing some workout videos soon too. So if you can keep an eye on the website, and you'll find out more about me there as well.
Sounds exciting stuff. Thanks for watching, and look out for more videos coming soon.